एवरीवन, दिस इज अखिलेश कुमार बिंद, पीजीटी इंग्लिश, केंद्रीय विद्यालय टेंगाबैली। आई होप यू ऑल विल बी फाइन। इन दिस क्लास वी विल डील विथ द सेकेंड टॉपिक ऑफ आवर सप्लीमेंट्री बुक विस्टा। द नेम ऑफ टॉपिक इज द टाइगर किंग बाय कल्कि। थ्रू द टॉपिक वी हैव अ ब्रीफ डिस्क्रिप्शन अबाउट द राइटर हुज पेन नेम इज कल्कि। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, हिज फुल नेम इज रामास्वामी अय्यर कृष्णमूर्ति एंड ही इज बेटर नोन बाय हिज पेन नेम कल्कि। ही वॉज बॉर्न ऑन 9th September इन 1899 इन तमिलनाडु। ही वॉज पॉपुलर तमिल राइटर, जर्नलिस्ट, पोएट, क्रिटिक एंड इंडियन इंडिपेंडेंस एक्टिविस्ट। His pen name Kalki was named after Kalki Avatar, the 10th and last avatar of the Hindu god Vishnu. His writings include over 120 short stories, 5 novels, 3 historical romances, editorial and political writings, and hundreds of film and music reviews. So, this is a brief description of the writer Kalki. Dear friends, as we all know, this is the topic from our supplementary book Vista. That's why we don't deal the topic word by word and line by line. That's why listen carefully. I will tell you some important points so that you can understand the topic easily. First of all, we have introduction of the topic. The Tiger King is a satire on the conceit of those in power. The story is a good mix of the supernatural, humor, and irony. The Tiger King has been magical from his birth. His arrogance takes him on a path of destruction of the tiger population. Now, this is the main point: tiger population. He is too much power drunk to notice the havoc he has created. His minions are scared of him and fail to guide him. Minions, his soldiers or his ministers who were with him. So this is a story of a person who has excessive person conceit. It's clear. Having excessive pride in their action or deeds or whatever they are. So, this is the introduction of the topic. Introduction of the topic, we have notable characters in the story. Dear friends, this is the story when in India there was British Raj, as you can see in the image. What is here? These are the dead bodies of tigers. Okay. Among notable characters, number one is the Tiger King. This is the main character of this story. This is protagonist of this story, the Tiger King. He was a man of courage and determination who could fight tigers with bare hand. He was a boy of miracle who could not only talk on the 10th day of his birth, but also could raise intelligent questions. As I have already told you that the Tiger King, from his birth, he was miracle. Okay, now you can see here, when he was mere only 10 days old, that time he began to speak. Not only began to speak, he also raised intelligent question. It's clear. So this is a brief description about the main character of this story, the Tiger King. The second one is astrologer. He was man of great knowledge, logic and wisdom, who knew everything about stars and their consequences, but probably committed a great mistake by prophesizing king's death. Okay, stars, you know, in which star we take birth. It's clear. Character is Diwan, and he also plays a very important part in this story. Diwan, or the prime minister of the state, he was supposed to offer appropriate suggestions to his ruler, but he fails miserably. And the fourth main character is the British officer. He was for tiger hunting, but Maharaja didn't allow him to do so. He came in the kingdom of the Tiger King to hunt tigers, but Maharaja didn't allow him to hunt in his kingdom. That's why, due to that reason, he had to face many problems. Hunting or animal hunting, it was not in old times only. Now we have also instances game hunting in recent times also. Okay. We can read in newspapers many times we see and find how people are hunting tigers. Tigers, not only tigers, a number of animals. So there have been some instances of game hunting in recent times also. Okay, even the affluent have been involved in the instances that illustrates the callousness of human beings towards wildlife. Be people how deal, how treat with wildlife, wild animals. We all know this. So some examples: Salman Khan. And we know about him, Salman Khan. He is a famous Bollywood actor. Now he is famous in this case, black buck poaching case. Second one is Nawab Mansur Ali Khan, antelope case. Okay. As you all know that India is a democratic country, as we all have our rights, in the same manner the tigers or animals also have some rights. Okay, that's why some laws are in our constitution to protect wildlife or animals. An insight into animal rights in India. Number one, It is the fundamental duty of every citizen of India to have compassion for all living creatures. Article 51A(z). Okay. Second one is to kill or maim any animal, including stray animals like dogs, is a punishable offence. And IPC sections 4-8 and 4-9. Number third, abandoning any animal for any reason can land you in prison for up to 3 months. Section 11 in bracket 1 Roman 1 and section 11 first J PCA Act 1960. So these are some laws to protect animals in India. Now we have the theme of this topic, the Tiger King. Theme of the story. The story, the Tiger King, is a satire on conceit of those in power. As I have told you in the introduction of the topic, most of the time the rulers are not interested in serving the people or work for the welfare of the public. Instead, they spend their time in foolish pursuits. They don't care their people. They only act foolishly. They pursue unnecessary things, unnecessary actions. Even the quietries who surround these power centers are interested in taking advantage of the proximity for their own benefit. Quietries means here a small group who are in powers, as bureaucrats, officials, CM, PMs in India. What they do? They only take advantage of other people and they only exploit for only their own benefit. This is a story about transience of life, of power, and reverberates the maxim, too many slips between a cup and leaf. Here, the meaning of this maxim is, don't Don't think about chicken before hatching the eggs. Sometimes we know the outcome. That outcome may be this and that, but that is time. Even certain outcomes can be changed. So this is here. This is the maxim here. Okay. So this is the theme of this story, The Tiger King. Now listen to the summary of this topic carefully. Okay. The beginning of this story. Listen carefully. When the king was born, the royal astrologer predicted that one day he must die. The 10 days old baby amazed everybody, saying, "O wise astrologer, we know that all must die. Tell me how I will die." As in the introduction of the topic, you know, in this story there is miracle, and from his birth he was miracle. Now you can see here, he was only 10 days old and he spoke. Not only spoke, he also raised intelligent question. Tell him how he will die. Hearing that, the astrologer said, "The holy prince was born in the hour of the bull. The bull and the tigers are enemies. So the tiger will kill the king, or he will be killed by a tiger." Hearing this prediction, but that prediction did not frighten the boy. He said, "Let the tigers beware." This was in roaring voice of that wise king. After the prediction, the prince comes of age. Now, when he grown up, that time he drank the milk of an English cow. The meaning is here, he was in English atmosphere that time. Brought up by an English nanny, he was tutored by an English teacher. He watched only English films. That time, this was a tradition of Indian kings, because that time there was British Raj, and English men were there, and in the surrounding of English atmosphere he grown up. It's clear. Prince comes of age at 20. When he comes at this age, he became the king of Pratibandhapuram state. The name of that state was Pratibandhapuram. Okay, when he came of age at 20, that time he became the king of Pratibandhapuram. When slowly the rumor came into the ears of Maharaja, or the tiger, the king, not tiger king that time, king, he decided to hunt the tigers in his self-defense. This was his opinion. Okay, so he began hunting tigers in self-defense, because he was told about the prediction of the chief astrologer when he was only 10 days old. He thought of the astrologer's prediction. He believed that the tiger was his enemy and he must kill him in self-defense. This was his decision. And in self-defense, we can kill even cow also if we are Hindu, and we all know that cow is very holy for us. That is religious animal in Hindu religion. We don't kill, but in self-defense, we can kill cow also. That's why he decided to hunt tigers. He went into the forest and killed his first tiger. He was happy. He proved the prediction wrong. And when he killed the first tiger, he was so happy and he thought he proved the prediction wrong. So he sent for the royal astrologer, and after that he sent for the royal astrologer, astrologer to come there and see what he said. The king was so excited because he was successful in killing the first tiger. And when that astrologer came there in the royal residence, that time astrologer stuck to his prediction. He said that the danger was not over. He also said that the king might kill 99 tigers. This figure, 99 tigers, but the 100th tiger could prove dangerous for his life. Okay, when the astrologer came second time, he said this, that he might kill 99 tigers, but the 100th tiger could prove dangerous for his life. He must be more cautious in his dealing with the 100th tiger. And the astrologer, he warned him, be careful dealing with the 100th tiger. So this was the suggestion of that astrologer. The suggestion of astrologer, he decided the king now he took vow that he will kill 100 tigers before paying attention to the affairs of the state. And he said, after killing only 100 tigers, I will pay notice to the affairs of the state. This was his foolish act. This was his foolish pursuit. He was king of that state, Pratibandhapuram, but in his power, he was so arrogant. He was so proud in his action. He said, only after killing 100 tigers, he will pay notice, he will pay attention to the affairs of the state. This was his promise, this was his resolution. He proclaimed that no one would kill a tiger in his kingdom except him. So now he began to misuse the law. Only for his own benefit, he banned the tiger hunting in his kingdom except him only. He then killed quite a number of tigers in a few months. And in a few months, he was able to kill many tigers in his state. He was killing the tigers in his own kingdom without paying attention to public affairs. Once he faced risk of losing the throne also. Wonder what happened? A high-ranking British officer visited Pratibandhapuram. He wanted to go on a hunting expedition, kill a tiger and get himself photographed with the dead tiger. This was the desire of that officer to hunt the tiger in that kingdom. And after hunting, he wanted to photograph with the dead tiger. But king refused permission even though the officer was not keen on killing. And when that officer, he sent a message that he himself will not kill the tiger, the Maharaja would kill the tiger, only he wanted to be photographed with a dead tiger. This was the only desire of when he was denied to hunt the tiger in the kingdom. That officer, he suggested this, but Maharaja did not agree even to this. This refusal could have cost the king his throne. And why did Maharaja not allow him even a photograph with that dead tiger? He thought if he allowed one officer, then other officers would come there and they would request to hunt tigers there. That's why he forbade at once. Okay, and due to that, his throne was in risk. There was a risk of his kingdom there, and that cost the king his throne. This was problem. He forbade a British officer who was very high ranking. That's why his throne was in danger. Then anyhow, he saved his throne. The Diwan and the king discussed how they could save the throne. They asked a famous British company of jewelers in Calcutta to send 50 chosen samples of diamond rings. The rings were sent to the wife of the British officer. It was hoped that she would choose one or two, but she accepted them all as a king's gift. They cost the king 3 lakh rupees, but the throne was safe. Okay, they know very well. They disappointed a British officer. There might be problem. That's why Diwan and the king discussed on that matter, and they gave order to a jewelers company in Calcutta, and that company sent them total 50 rings of diamond. And they thought the wife of British officer, she would choose one or two, and she would send them back after selecting one or two. But that wife of that British officer, she accepted them all rings, total 50 rings, she accepted as a gift, from the king. And the cost of those 50 rings were 3 lakh rupees. That time, he had to spend 3 lakh rupees. But he was able to save his throne. Okay, so this happens when we don't follow the rules, when we only do whatever we like in power. The king anyhow killed 70 tigers in his kingdom. After that, the population of tigers disappeared from the kingdom of Pratibandhapuram. After that, the king decides to marry. The king killed 70 tigers in the forest in Pratibandhapuram. Now, no tigers were left in his territory. So, that's why he decided to marry the daughter of a king whose forest had a large number of tigers. This was his purpose in getting married with that girl. The Diwan found a state had a large number of tigers and a marriageable daughter. This work was done by the Diwan of that state, and the Diwan found such a state where had a large number of tigers and a marriageable daughter. And then every time after marrying with that girl in a royal family, every time he visited his father-in-law, he would kill a few tigers. Whenever he visited his father-in-law, he killed 5 to 6 tigers. At last, he had killed 99 tigers in all. In this way, he was able to kill 99 tigers in all. This was. But still, one tiger lived. 99 tigers, but still, there left one tiger to complete his figure of 100. That's why he began to search the 100th tiger. Now the king could not find an alive tiger, neither in his own forest nor his father-in-law's. Then, but he had to kill the 100th tiger to be safe. But he had to kill 100th tiger to be safe for his life. He learned that sea were disappearing fast in a hillside village. So they heard a news that from a hillside village, the sheep were disappearing. It was presumed that there was a tiger there. And when they confirmed no one was stealing the sheep, they presumed that was the act of the tiger. The king set up a camp there and decided not to leave until the mission was accomplished. Now, this was his act to kill the last tiger, only they presumed. That was not clear whether there was tiger or not. But he went there, he camped there and decided not to leave until his mission was accomplished. What was his mission? To kill 100 tigers. But no tigers appeared. He was waiting there, but no tiger appeared. The king grew impatient. Due to that, the king became angry and he became impatient. His anger, when he got message that from hillside village sheep were disappearing, he was happy and he announced that they would not take the land tax from that village for 3 years. Okay, but when he did not find the tiger and he became impatient and anger, then he began to act aggressively. What he did first? The king expressed his displeasure to the Diwan. The Diwan felt that he might lose his job if the king did not get the 100th tiger. He had an old tiger hidden in his house. But anyhow, Diwan found a tiger which was hidden in his house. At night, the Diwan and his old wife managed to get the tiger into their car. With great difficulty, they were able to push him out and leave him there. Anyhow, they managed to bring that old tiger that was from Lion's Park. Not Lion's Park, from Mince Park, that tiger was hidden in the house of Diwan. And it is not clear how that tiger came into the house of Diwan. But when they found that old tiger, very soon the Diwan decided to offer that old tiger in the forest where the king was waiting to hunt his last tiger. Okay, with great difficulty they were able to push him out and leave him there means in the forest where the king was waiting for last tiger. And Diwan left that old tiger in the forest. Next morning, what happened? When the king, he saw that tiger, next morning the tiger was sighted, the king sought it. When the tiger found in front of him that tiger, he was so excited and he sought that tiger. The king was happy because he had accomplished his mission. And that condition of tiger was very bad. The tiger was too old, the tiger could not run. And the tiger was there without any movement, but the king sought him. That's why the king was happy, because he had accomplished his mission. What was his mission? Killing 100 tigers. He ordered that the tiger should be carried to the town in a grand procession. In that kingdom, in royal residence, in a grand manner. But the hunters found that the tiger was alive. But when the hunters, they went near to the tiger, they found the tiger was alive. The king had missed his mark. The bullet of king did not hit the tiger, did not kill the tiger. The bullet had gone whizzing past the tiger's ear, had fainted with the shock. And when that bullet of king passed through the ears of the tiger, due to the whizzing sound of that bullet, the tiger fainted due to shock. But the hunters wanted to keep it a secret from the Maharaja, so they shot the tiger dead. And they wanted to keep the secret, the tiger was not dead, by the bullet of the tiger king. They themselves shot that. Why did they do that? Because they were scared of Maharaja. If they tell him, they might lose their jobs also. That's why they didn't tell him, and they themselves shot tiger dead. The order of the Maharaja to bring that dead tiger in the kingdom in a grand procession. When the tiger was brought in the town, and then the tiger was buried with honor. It was a day of celebration. The tiger was buried with honor, and a tomb was raised over it. Where the tiger was buried, they erected a tomb. Okay. Tiger King thought he had killed 100 tigers. Now he was hopeful. He realized now his life was saved, and that's why he was so happy. He thought to pay attention to his family, whom he could not give time. The king felt he was safe when he thought he had killed 100 tigers. After a few days, it was his son's birthday. Okay, before that he was never with him. He didn't give quality time with him. That's why he wanted to gift him some unique thing on that day. King wished to give him a suitable present. He chose to give a wooden tiger toy. and he began to search some suitable version. At last, he found a tiger toy. It was an ordinary toy carved by unskilled hands, and he found, now we can see how it was carved. It was made by an unskilled carpenter or person. It had slivers all over on the body of the toy tiger king, there were slivers. The shopkeeper said that it was worth 300 rupees, but the king took it away as a gift. The cost of that wooden tiger was not too much, that was very cheap, but he was Maharaja, that's why the shopkeeper said the value of that toy tiger was 300 rupees. That shopkeeper lied because he knew he was the king, he was the Maharaja, that's why he could not say a lower price of anything. The 100 tigers had its revenge. On the birthday of his son, Maharaja thought to give him a suitable present, and when he found a toy tiger, then what happened? The king and his son were playing with the wooden tiger on that day. On the birthday of his son, the king and his son were playing with that wooden tiger. A sliver pierced the king's hand. This happened. Okay, a sliver from the body of that toy tiger that pierced the king's hand. He removed it, but the infection developed into a terrible sore. Okay, he removed that sliver. Okay, but that infection developed into a terrible sore. But in his hand, his hands were infected by that. Three famous surgeons from Madras operated upon the king. At the end, the surgeons announced, "The operation was successful. The king is dead." At last, what happened? Three surgeons, they came and they operated upon the king. And at the end, the surgeons announced, "The operation was successful, but the king is dead." Ironically, the mighty king who had killed 99 tigers was killed by a wooden tiger. Now see, this irony we discussed earlier, how it happens. That mighty king who was so mighty, so powerful, so strong, who had killed 99 tigers, but at last he was killed by a wooden tiger. Just thus, the king was metaphorically killed in the way it was predicted. So we can say how there was prediction of that astrologer. In that manner, he was killed. At last, the prediction of that astrologer became true. That was proved when he was killed by that wooden tiger. Some word meanings you can take help from here. This home assignment for you people. There are only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 questions for you. So write the answers in your notebook. It's clear? Thank you everyone. I hope this lesson will help you to understand the topic easily. If any problem, so ask me without any hesitation. We have discussed key points, introduction, about characters, about the writer, about the summary, about the theme, and about the irony and satire. If any problem, any doubt, so ask me. Once again, thank you everyone.